we ask the Blessed Sacrament. The Blessed Sacrament is the real presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, body, blood, soul, and divinity, under the appearances of bread and wine. In John chapter 6, verse 55, Jesus said, "My flesh is real meat, and my blood is real drink." Flesh is humanity. Blood is humanity. God became flesh and blood to prove his love for us and how much he desires us to be saved. In the Immaculate Womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the miracle of the Eucharist began through the action, through the power of the Holy Spirit. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Mary gave flesh and blood to God, who is all in all. In this unfolding, the bones of Mary became the bones of God. The flesh and blood of Mary became the flesh and blood of God. In the unfolding of the Incarnation, God becoming one of us, God took the DNA of Mary. God needed the help of a woman. God chose her. God purified her. God highly exalted her above all women and came down from heaven through the Archangel Gabriel, as we have it in Luke chapter 1, 26-28, to seek her consent and seek her approval. And Mary said in Luke chapter 1, verse 38, "Let it be done to me according to thy word." And the miracle took place. Therefore, God the Holy Spirit commingled with the chromosomes of Mary, and conception took place at God's power through the perfect blending of the human and the divine. What a holy interface, bringing about our redemption from slavery. The first Adam in the Garden of Eden rejoiced when he saw Eve, and he shouted, "At last, the bone of my bone, the flesh of my flesh." Now, the new Adam also, who is Christ, rejoiced in the garden of the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and rejoices for all eternity with Mary, the new Eve, who is bone of his bones and flesh of his flesh. Mary is the bone of Christ's bones. She is the flesh of Christ's flesh. She is the blood of Christ's blood. So when we shout the blood of Jesus, Mary's blood is also involved. When we call upon the flesh of Christ, Mary's flesh is also involved, because Christ took from Mary's flesh and blood. Because Christ took humanity from the Blessed Virgin Mary. The first Eucharistic consecration took place in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary with the Incarnation. And the first Eucharistic procession was Mary's visit to Elizabeth. Mary's womb was the first tabernacle ever to house God Himself. At birth, Jesus suckled the Father's obedience and spiritual discipline from Mary, and no one born of a woman in human history or in the scripture has ever adored God as much as Mary. Mary carried Jesus, the God-made man, in her womb. Mary gave birth to God. Mary adored the Lord in the 30 years of his private ministry, through the 3 years of his public ministry, till he died on the cross. While Jesus was on the cross, Mary was there. He resurrected, Mary was there. The connection between Jesus and Mary are inseparable, just like the connection between a child and mother are inseparable. For all eternity, Mary remains connected to Jesus. Mary's entire life was Christ-centered, Christocentric. Therefore, every Marian devotion today, every Marian spirituality, every Marian discipline must be Christocentric. Any Marian piety that is not Christocentric is not acceptable. Mary leads us to Christ. Mary tells us, do whatever he tells you. May Mother Mary intercede for us, her children, to love Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament to the end of time. May the power of the Eucharist, through Mother Mary's intercession, bring us salvation. Through Mary's intercession, may the Holy Eucharist transform our lives, heal our world of coronavirus, and heal all those who are sick with coronavirus, and bless all families, and grant our heart's desires. Through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, may we receive salvation, may we become victorious in our battles. Because Jesus in the Eucharist has prevailed, you too shall prevail. Because Jesus has conquered, you too shall conquer. Through Mary, our mother, we shall succeed. May the Lord answer our prayers. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you and with your spirits.